Hello, my friend. Welcome to Tubio Channel. Stable diffusion is a latent text-to-image diffusion motor that can generate various images based on your text input, known as a prompt. The effectiveness of getting your desired image heavily depends on the prompt technique used. Today, I will introduce you to the prompt strategy based on my understanding of the stable diffusion prompt. Let's get started. In general, the more specific details you provide, the better images stable diffusion will generate. Therefore, you need a specific topic to tell the stable diffusion what you want to generate. However, finding the right prompt can be challenging. To make things easier, I have collected several useful resources for you. Get some ideas from the internet. You can use resources like Lexica to find a relevant prompt. When you find the appropriate image, click on it to view detailed information about the image. Then copy the positive and negative prompt to the Web UI Automatic 1111 in the corresponding area. Prompt Hero. This is a good place to search for prompts for Stable Diffusion, Midjourney, DALL-E, and ChatGPT respectively. When you click on a relevant image, it will show the prompt with a lot of detailed information. Use them as a starting point for your image. Prompt Examples. They also list many examples, including detailed prompt information. You can also try the demo Stable Diffusion if you have not installed the SD Web UI on your computer. OpenArt. This is another good place to start, where you can even train your model. When you click on an image, it will show you many similar images and the detailed prompt information. Regarding this homepage, there is another benefit, our next attempt. Read books to learn more about Stable Diffusion and a prompt. It is published on OpenArt and introduces the basic knowledge of the Stable Diffusion and the secret to generating good images. You can copy and paste the prompt to your Web UI and try it out. The seed is not useful since we use a different motor. You can see the generated images are quite similar. Here, you can learn about some elements that will influence the image a lot and how to modify your image using modifiers. It includes everything that you need to know and gives some examples for trying. You should read this book first. From this book, we know an important rule. The prompt format is very important, and there are several rules you should obey. First, even though it supports other languages, such as Japanese, using English is the best way. Always use English as the input language. Using Google Translate is a good choice. Second, use normal English writing structure, but only the keywords will take control. For example, we can say, I like spaghetti, and it will generate a spaghetti image for you. But if you say, although I like spaghetti, I want to eat a hamburger now, it will generate a spaghetti and hamburger mixture food. All the other words such as, although, I, like, etc. are omitted. So here, the keywords are spaghetti and hamburger. If you misspell spaghetti to spaghetti, it will still generate the correct image. The AI knows you made a clear mistake, so it corrects the mistake for you. But if you misspell hamburg to hamba, then this error cannot be fixed. Third, use normal English sentence elements to express your topic. Subject, person, man, girl, animal, place, scene, etc. Verb, reading, standing, walking, eating, etc. Object, similar to subject. And adjective, beautiful, realistic, golden, young, etc. Fourth, Stable Diffusion will treat your prompt according to the sequence. Put the important keyword first. Also, the keywords can be modified with weight value. For example, parentheses will increase the weight to 1.1 times. Double parentheses will increase it to 1.21. This will decrease the weight value to 0.9. Or you can directly write the weight value in parentheses. For example, word column 1.2 means to increase the weight to 1.2. Also, the weight can be blended. For example, oil painting portrait of cat, dog, column 0.2 using step 20. The first four steps we used cat, and the following 16 steps we used dog as a motor. Here, we show the changing effect of the different weights. Let's discuss the condition that influence prompt generation. This includes the environment, indoor, outdoor, tavern, park, etc. Lighting, soft, ambient, foggy, neon, etc. Tools and materials, pencil, chalk, charcoal, crayon, etc. Color scheme, vibrant, pastel, dark, dynamic lighting, etc. And the camera, long shot, wide angle, close up, fish eye, etc. Now let's talk about the modifiers. Using photographs as an example, we can use these modifiers individually or mix them up. This includes the art idiom, oil painting, watercolors, sketch, photograph, etc. Art style, manga, fantasy, graffiti, sci-fi, etc. And art inspiration, Pablo Picasso, Van Gogh, Da Vinci, Michelangelo, etc. There are several websites that discuss artists using by AI such as Stable Diffusion. You can find a list of over 1,800 artists for Stable Diffusion and view some examples here. You can also find more detailed information about the artists as well as other information about prompt generation. In Google Docs, there is a database listed more than 3,400 artists which can be used in Stable Diffusion, but not everyone has been tested yet. This is not a conclusive list for all parameters that influence Stable Diffusion image in generation. It simply provides a starting point to help you write good prompts. To make things easier, you can use the SD Web UI extension function. Go to the extension tab, click available submenu, then load from in search column. Input prompt generator and click install. If you haven't installed it yet, from the installed submenu, click check for updates, restart webuiuser.bat and refresh webui automatic 1111. Now you can see a new tab called prompt generator. This extension can generate prompts for you based on Gustav Vosta and Fred Zahn's models. Gustav Vosta's model is based on Lexica Art, which extracted more than 80,000 data sets. By clicking this button, you can see the detailed prompt and the image pairs they used. Fred Zahn's model is based on Lexica Art, Stable Diffusion Discord, and his hand-picked prompts, totaling more than 2 million prompts. Using Fred Zahn's model is a more effective way to generate prompts. You can use most default parameters as a starting point. Change how many to generate to the number you want to generate at once. And check use punctuation item to use commas in the output. Otherwise, the prompt will consist of all words. Now let's try using a girl walking in the park. The first time you run it, it will take time to download the model. Then you can see the output prompt. You can then send it directly to text-to-image or image-to-image and start generating images. I recommended a useful extension called DAAM, which stands for Diffusion Attentive Attribution Maps. From the extension tab, search for DAAM and install it. From the installed submenu, check for updates and apply and restart UI. You may need to restart webuiuser.bat and reload the UI. Now, in the text to image and image image tab, there is additional attempt heatmap item. Click to use it. In the attention text column, you need to input the attention words or phrases that you used in your prompt. A simple way is to copy the prompt here. Keep other parameters as default. After generating an image, it will show the attention heat map along with the image. You can see how the words or phrases influence your image. If you want to enhance some parts, change the weight is the easiest way. For example, I want to draw a picture using the prompt below. A girl walking in the park at night, best quality, masterpiece. If I change it at night to 0.1, it is almost not a night picture. Unfortunately, it will not work on high resolution fixed condition. Using it as a reference is a good idea. Of course, the negative prompt can influence the image quite a lot. Fortunately, most of them are commonly filling in most cases, such as disfigured, deformed, low quality, bad anatomy, pixelated, blurry, etc. We can put them together and add more if the generated image have some defect parts you want to improve. Adjust the sequence or add weight until it fits your desire. Other parameters such as CFG, step, motor will influence the image a lot. I will introduce you how to find the best combination of them in the following video. If you're enjoying my content, please consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching.